show you every side, yeah, how you can get it back. Yeah, cause I ain't never done, I'll be number one, working hella hard until I get just what I want. Yeah, rises like the sun, yeah, fatal like a gun. Shooters gonna shoot and I'm gonna shoot until I fall. Yeah, always do it on my own, so I gotta get through it. And the only thing I know is to love what I'm doing. Never give up, never slow till I finally prove it. Never listen to the no's, I just wanna keep moving. Yeah, I put out all this art, it's my only medicine. Yeah, everything I do, I'm just being genuine. Yeah, I'm sick of being screwed, feel my own adrenaline. Yeah, I do just what I do, and I hope you let me in, yeah. Always do it on my own, so I gotta get through it. And the only thing I know is to love what I'm doing. Never give up, never slow, till I finally prove it. Never listen to the no's, I just wanna keep moving. Keep my head up when I act, head up, that's a fact. Never looking back, I'ma keep myself on track. Keep my head up, staying strong, always moving on. Feel I don't belong, tell my thoughts to move along. Push myself to be the best, die with no regrets. Live with every breath, see my message start to spread. And I had so many dreams, then you hit your teens. Life ain't really what it seems, try to find out what it means. Always do it on my own.
Alright guys, how's it going? We're going to be getting started in just a couple minutes. We are going to be streaming Pathfinder Kingmaker, following the story and tale of Trish Beastcaller. Loading up our save right here. And I'll just recount what we did last time before we get started this time. Quick pause, take a look at our characters. So we just recently hit level 6 last time. We leveled up as a Defender of the True World, Druid, continued Sacred Hunts Master for Amiri. We have been going into the Sorcerer build. I'm not sure if I'm going to want to continue that. I feel like we're wasting strength and other attributes, and we're just kind of throwing away this Inquisitor level. We might look at redoing that and maybe going Inquisitor 3 and then the rest in like a cleric build that focuses on necromancy. Because we're still planning on being in melee, so we'll just kind of have to see what we end up wanting to do with that. But that's what we currently have her as. Sorcerer 5, it does give her access to a lot of different spells. As you can see, we have 7 castings of all these, 5 castings of all these, and we might, for now, let her stay this way, but then as we start to get to higher levels, we might retrain her and respec her later on down the road. We'll just kind of see how we're feeling about it. Tristan, We are still going the Mist of Thurge route. I really feel like that's a great kind of route for him. It gives him plenty of offensive capabilities, as well as plenty of universality and healing capabilities as well. So we're going to keep going that route with him, I think. The only downside is he doesn't become a true strong healer as he has in the past, but that's okay. We're still going to kind of focus on his healing ability as well as his damaging ability. So he's going to be kind of best of both worlds. At least that's what we're hoping. And then Lindsay, we're going down the kind of path of a Eldritch Knight. So hopefully she'll be able to start doing some decent damage. We currently have a crossbow with her. I'm not sure if we're going to keep with a crossbow or if we're going to go a different route, like maybe a longbow or something like that. But as of right now, she does some decent damage for us because she does have that rogue level. Gives her sneak attack. We've got the accomplished sneak attacker right here. And then we'll, of course, also start to get better to hit bonuses and things like that as we progress into the Eldritch Knight, which I think we will start in about another 2 or 3 levels. I think we have to get a proficiency for her and then get our third level spells. We only have second level right now. So, that is our plan, at least for now, for her. And that gets everyone that's in our party right now. This will probably be a very similar set of people that we're going to keep for a while. I do want to introduce Ekandayu, which is the ranger for the campaign. I might end up dropping Jethal for him eventually. I haven't decided. Which if we do drop Jethal for him, then that'll resolve our issue with trying to figure out what we want to do with her. But that's just something we haven't completely decided on. We have 1, 2, 3, 4... Oh, we only have 5 people, so we don't have to drop anyone. He'll just join our group. So we only have 5 people in our party right now, so he'll just kind of join the group once we find him. And I believe we'll find him sometime in this next chapter coming up, so it shouldn't be too terribly long. So we found this stone troll, killed some bandits. We're in the Lone House map. We've just been exploring some of our territory. And we're kind of looking to see what all is in this area.
It's just not my lucky day.
Those are DC 20s, so she doesn't need to roll high.
Adventures call to them.
Does she have guidance?
No. You have my attention.
She does.
What troubles you?
Okay, so we've got +1 there. I can give us a +2 here. We're going to do that, so that gives us +3, so we're not going to fail very easily.
Anything else?
There we go. Okay.
Help! Help!
Anything is possible.
We'll disarm this, then go see what Wayne
boss,
over here
please.
Is eating.
The way seems clear.
Somebody save me!
Did our game freeze? Oh no. It looks like we have a frozen game. Okay, there we go. Oh. And the game crashed. Bear with me for 1 second, guys. We're getting it back. Just technical difficulties. Game crashed on us. Reload and do those skill checks again.
The way seems clear.
Request.
I'll do her guidance on the...
Adventures call to them.
And do her bonus.
Anything else?
Keep walking.
I see something. What troubles you?
The same thing.
Ask.
Lindsay the Magnificent? Lindsay the Illustrious? Something more simple like Lindsay the Great? Maybe Lindsay the Indecisive?
Save me!
Come save me. Alright. Wayne, a barefoot young man in tattered clothes stands before you. His eyes dart about wildly, and his hair matted, and his matted hair sticks up in dirty spikes. Help! Help! The young man yells, even though you're right in front of him. What's wrong with you? What happened? Help! The man's scream subsides as he finally notices the presence. Wayne! He manages at last. His eyes are wide, so wide that they look like they might fall out of his sockets. He's mad in the head. Let him rot. So Wayne, what happened? Traitors! We're traitors! Lexan and me! Wayne waves his hand vaguely as he relaxes. He starts to babble. We usually come to visit the local mage, bring him food, and he gives us magic trinkets in exchange. We last came a month ago, left him some supplies. We were riding back today, and we wanted to stop and pick up an order he promised to complete. Well, Lexan stayed to guard the cart, while I went to the mage's house. This mage has a bunch of traps around his house, scares off the trolls, you see. He even put a warning sign up on the road, so people wouldn't get hurt. You just have to stick to the road. Trolls are stupid, they can't read, so they get caught. But I didn't stick to the road. I thought I saw something glittering in the underbrush. As soon as I approached, boom! Suddenly I was flying upside down. Wayne lifts his hand sharply to mimic the blast. When I landed, I was too scared to move. So many traps around. I wouldn't survive a second boom. Cowards like this make me sick. He'd shit himself at the sight of a rabbit. So do you want to get back on the road? How long have you been standing there? Where are your boots? We'll ask him if he wants to get back onto the road. Wayne begins frantically nodding, then stops, thinks the matter over, and begins frantically shaking his head instead. Enough sniveling. One hit from me will fix him. Alright, Mary, he's yours. Diplomacy, intimidate. Let's see here. The way back to the road is for you. Traps, Wayne. We just came from there after we heard you screaming. Come on, we'll make sure you get back safely. How about this? You head towards the road, I follow. You falter, I'll kick you so hard, make it the rest of the way airborne. Too scared to make it the road, that's just steps away. Those traps would be doing the world a favor. Well, I don't want to be mean. And I feel like the intimidate and this option down here is kind of mean. So, I think we're just going to diplomatize them. It's the lawful good act, which we aren't lawful good. We're actually kind of more neutral, but we're going to still kind of choose this. Because I kind of feel bad for the man. He's just a traitor and being trapped in all these explosive traps. I'll try. Just stay near, please. Maybe hold my hand? Or could you carry me? Please? Could you? I'm not carrying you, my man. Look, you got this.
If there's gold,
good thing you didn't go that way. You made it. Found a bastard sword, plus one. Looks like these bandits died after triggering a trap. Alright, Wayne, you made it.
But thank you!
Wayne's teeth still chattering, but he seems to be focusing better.
Thank you, you saved my life! I have nothing to give as a reward. I never made it to the mage's house, after all. And now I never will. To hell with him,
Wayne sighs. You'd best find Leskin. He's probably still waiting for me near the cart on the road. Tell him I'm on my way. He'll reward you. So we just gotta kind of follow the road, I guess. Find Leskin.
Serves you right. Can you make an epic pose? I need inspiration.
See, this guy's going first, so we'll charge in there. We'll let him charge in over here. Get some damage out nicely. I don't think we need to use any magic or anything. I'll help over
Repent!
Here. It won't matter, we miss.
You deserved it!
Yeah, there we go. Okay. I will. I guess just
your
up
death
over here.
Awaits.
Not gonna really cast a spell at bandits, so. Of Amiri run
Tear
up and
them
whack
apart!
This guy. And Jethal pick a bit of spells. We'll throw a magic missile as well. Alright, this will finish him off. And the bear will finish this guy off. And that'll be that. And we'll keep on going our merry way.
Quiet footsteps.
Uh-oh. That looks like Leviston.
Yes, yes.
And we have a conjurer. Sorry, gone. These guys haven't. Let's hurry
Any
this guy.
Last wishes?
Get some sneak attack damage on him. He's gonna come up here.
I need a moment to recover.
You forced my hand.
There we go. The bear might be able to finish this guy. Oh. Only if we hit. Charge in on this guy. And miss. Nice. Bear's corpse is still warm. He died. That's disappointing. Oh yeah, we did get a lot more wild shapes now at our disposal as well. For what it's throw up a bunch of mites down.
Unworthy.
End it.
They go down!
Get a good hit on him.
Yes, yes.
I'm okay with him summoning in some more monsters, because that's going to take his turn, and hopefully we're going to kill him in just a second.
This is where I step in.
I'll try to make this swift.
Missed. We'll go ahead and try to kill this wolf. Just so that he can't pose us any other danger later on. And then he'll finish him off. And then our mites should be able to go and take out that guy. We'll just loot this guy for now. And move up over here. We'll just kind of move up over here. I don't really see a need for us to really get too crazy. Amiri can get over. Okay, we've already looted that guy. We'll loot. Agile fist. There, get some herbs over here. reconvene. Proceed with caution. Traps ahead. There's our warning for the traps.
Precisely.
So I guess let's go and talk to Wayne again. See what he says about his compatriot being killed. Finish exploring this kind of little area up along while we're at it. And there we go, we got some herbs.
That's easy.
Yeah, that's all we're gonna find here. Yeah. Alright, so let's talk to Wayne. Thank you! Wayne's teeth still chattering. Thank you, you saved my life. Alright, that's what he said last time. We found Levskin. He's dead. Here's his brooch. Give it to his relatives so they have something to them by. Or we can just tell him that he's dead. How much is the brooch worth, I wonder? I didn't look. I kind of feel bad for this guy. We're gonna give him the brooch. Dead? That's awful! May Pharasmus save his soul. Yes, Leskin bought this brooch for his wife. Said it was a birthday present. Thank you. I'll make sure she gets it. And thanks again for all you've done for me today. So we lost the turquoise brooch. Gained 900 experience. Valued at 250, we'd probably only get like 125 gold. So it wasn't a huge loss on our part. If that's what got us the larger amount of experience, then I'm okay with that.
And right. Lindsay was called Jake for it.
Saul,
share your trouble. You are going to
ask guidance on Lindsay.
Just letting the ink dry.
You're gonna come up here, give yourself a boost, and try to disarm that.
Applause, please.
There we go.
Quiet footsteps.
What's that?
We'll do the
State
same thing
your
again.
Desire.
Guidance on Lindsay.
Anything is possible.
Here. Fire competence. Disarm.
I failed. I'm sorry. Applause, please.
We had to do two rounds of it that time, but that's okay.
What's that glitter?
Alright, maybe...
I always have the upper hand.
We
done
should...
with you.
Share your will.
How may I help?
What troubles you?
Heal up some.
Right here, my friend.
Yes, yes.
Just to make sure that we don't get too low before a fight. And then...
Speak.
Now we can just talk. And that way, if the trap goes off, then no one's in danger of going down.
I wrote it like I saw it.
He's like right on top of that trap.
Anything else?
The way
you
seems
see that?
Clear.
Are these all relatively... Yeah, some of them do. Okay, yeah, we're gonna keep doing this. We haven't really needed the
adventures call to that.
Bardic stuff for combat, so I'm okay with using it for traps. If it means that we get 200 experience per
applause,
trap and we
please.
Don't get hit by them, definitely okay with doing that.
Careful now. If there's gold,
God, there's
it's mine.
So many of these. We're going to do the same thing here. We're just going to...
Request.
Guidance.
Just letting the ink dry. Applause, please.
Some nice... things from that trunk. Spotted a rubble. A dwarven helm guard. Bartholomew Delgado. This is the guy that I was talking about. Yeah, if we can successfully talk to him, then we're going to have a chance of getting another advisor here. I don't know if he comes now or later on in the game, but there's a chance for us getting him. I don't know if we've disabled all of the craft.
Anything
very
is
much
possible.
So concerns me. We're going to do one round of fire.
What troubles you?
And we're going to run over this way, see if we can get a craft with that. Nope. I have already disabled him. I do think we disabled this one already, because down where saw that guy. Down there. Awesome. This bark is charred and blackened in places.
What's that?
There's two more. Stone is covered with soot. Alright, get all Lindsay. Yar up. Guidance.
And Lindsay was called for.
Something bothering you?
I wrote it like I saw it.
I want that.
Anything else?
Almost out of bardic songs for the day, but
it's just not my lucky day.
Oh, I forgot.
State your desire.
Ooh, without that plus two, we might have like completely felt that. Guidance.
Adventures call to them.
I think the reason we want to do both of these bonuses is because
I failed. I'm sorry.
Now I don't think we can. Just outright
share
explode
your will.
It, unless a one does anyway.
Just letting the ink dry.
Maybe the case. But...
I'm sorry.
Lindsay triggered the trap. A one does just explode it, regardless of how many pluses we have. So. Okay. So if they're 22, and Lindsay has. What's her thievery? Trickery is a 13 normally, so if they're a 22 and you have to get more than 5 below to cause them to explode, 13 plus 5 is 18, plus 1 from guidance, 19. So if we do just guidance, it'll be a 2 or a 1 cause it to.
What's that glitter?
What troubles you?
Speak.
Oh, guidance.
Anything is possible. Applause, please.
Yeah, I'll take it. If we only fell one out of all of these traps, I think I'm okay with that.
Precisely.
Down here was where the troll was, so I think we've explored everything. Except for up here where Bartholomew was. Let's go and talk to Bartholomew. Mr. Delgado himself.
You see that?
That's easy.
Now before we get another trap.
Ask.
And Lindsay was called for it. Applause, please.
Nice.
The way seems clear.
Alright, so who's our best persuasive individual? Lindsay has plus 13. Micah just 9.
Plus 0.
6. Plus 9. So it looks like Lindsay's gonna be our best option. So,
request.
Since we're gonna be doing. Persuasion. We're going to guidance Lindsay to give her that little bump in case we have to persuade him. middle-aged man stands before you. His clothes are not too gaudy, but tasteful. Despite living in the wilderness, he looks well-groomed, even dapper. His mustache is slick, and the nails on agile, soft hands are meticulously polished.
What a pleasure! Welcome, Your Grace. Would you like a cup of tea? Something stronger, perhaps? It's a great honor for a humble hermit entertaining such an important personage. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Bartholomew Delgado, at your service. How may I be of assistance?
Do you have anything for sale? You seem to be an educated man. What are you doing out in these woods? There's traps in the woods. Are they yours? We'll get a little information from him.
They're mine, yes. You see, while I'm happy to welcome guests, I prefer those who are capable of coherent speech. I've neither interest in nor desire to waste my time with fighting off every monster that comes across my dwelling. But I did leave a safe message for those who could read. I even installed a sign. You must have seen it.
Give me your friends. So what if someone can't read? Bartholomew shrugs.
Literacy is one of humanity's most significant achievements. Trust me, my traps aren't even close to the worst damage threatening anyone who chose to remain in the darkness of ignorance. Though, I suppose if I ever meet a painter here, I could ask them to add a picture to my warning sign.
Rock troll in the woods nearby, is it real? What about local bandits? Do they bother you here? Sometimes even those who can read you caught in your traps. Crater by the name of Wayne, for instance. The rock troll, is it real?
Oh yes, I'm quite proud of that one, actually. You see, trolls rarely perish in traps. If they manage to break free from one, their animal cunning usually helps them avoid further traps. But that rock troll was trapped just before dawn, so he had no way to avoid the sunrise. Now he just stands there, serving as a demonstration of sorts. It's useful, both for my research and as a ward against unwelcome guests.
What about the local bandits? We did run into several that were on the road. Did they bother you?
They tried once. Now they make every effort to stay away. They only show up if they don't have any other options. And even then, they just politely ask me to enchant their arrows.
Sometimes even those who can read get such as Wayne.
Oh, Wayne? Frankly, I wonder what was going on in his brain that he'd rush into the forest being perfectly aware of the danger. Obviously, if you hadn't rescued him, I would. Just a bit later, after he'd learned his lesson.
Fair enough. Thanks for satisfying my curiosity.
I'm always happy to help those who seek knowledge.
Do you have anything for sale?
Certainly.
Oh, okay. Check it out. Sounds like there's going to be some giants and stuff nearby. Maybe we pick up a giant slayer necklace. Ooh, bag of holding. We always want to get those. I don't remember what transmutation book we have, but... we have part 2. Don't have part 3, it doesn't look like. I mean, part 1, so... let's go ahead and grab the part 1. We are going to need that later. Plus 2 ring of protection. I think we only have plus 1. But I'm not sure if we want to spend the money on this yet. Might just hold off for now. Call it a deal, we get both of these.
Take us all this and we only spend 600 gold. Oh, excuse me.
We only spend 600 gold, so. Works for me. Seems like a fair enough deal. Let's see, what is it? Wand of Acid Arrows. Scorching Ray, Acid. They're really kind of gearing you up for the next chapter where it is going to be a lot of trolls. I really kind of feel like that's what they're pushing with all of that stuff. Alright, so he has some things that we might end up picking up, like the Ring of Protection plus 2, Cloak of Resistance plus 2, but for right now I think we're okay. Alright, let's talk to him some more. You seem to be an educated man. What are you doing in these woods?
I'm simply a humble researcher in the field of esoteric sciences, and I've chosen this location to work in peace.
away from the noise of the city. When the environment is quiet and air is fresh, ink just begs set to paper. Question about the traps. I've already gotten all those. It's time to leave. Farewell. That's everything we can do. So I guess we can't get them yet. Okay, hold on. If Lindsay is going
to be. I wrote it like I saw it.
Trying to open that, we're going to
state
give her
your desire.
Best potential outcome possible. I'll tell you what we might actually do, because Amiri is a few points lower than Lindsay.
I'm listening.
We'll let her try first.
Done.
I was going to say, we could see the DC if she fails, and then have an idea of if we need to buff Lindsay further, but... A cozy house stands away from the main roads, an excellent place for a hermit. I think we can go into this little house down here. Oh, we need a key. But this might be all that we have as far as what we can do here. He's just a person that we can buy stuff from currently. But we'll at some point talk to him and be able to hopefully coax him into joining our kingdom. But for now, that's everything that we can do here at the Lone House. Alright, so, we don't have any kingdom events popping up currently. I think we are probably, we still have a lot of areas to explore, like all of this down here, but we don't want to get into a point where we're fighting things that are too difficult for us, so we'll probably wait on the dire gnarl marches. Because that starts to get more powerful stuff. We do have to help the tiefling out. And we're still waiting for Amiri. Meet the nymph near the verdant chamber. We do still have to do that. Maybe we attempt that with our party. We make our way out to the Verdant Chamber. The Bald Hilltop, when was that happening? 34 days. So we still have plenty of time for that. That's Sorrow Flow. We also need to go all the way up there, which we can explore kind of out along this path on the way up and then come back. There's just a lot that we could do. I think what we're going to do, we're going to continue doing this kind of little path down and around following along this river. We're not going to go to Candlemere yet. We'll go there eventually. Spotted enemies. Fight! Where are these settings? There we go. Kobold.
Stay on your toes.
We're probably gonna be resting relatively soon, so why don't we go ahead and get some summons going.
Magritium Turinos. Magritium Turinos. Magritium Turinos.
Oh, that is a lot of kobolds. A lot more than I was expecting. Take out that kobold. Yep, there we go. Before I continue, I wanted to make sure that we aren't sharing XP. Okay, only active companions receive experience. Yep, we're good. Lindsay, let's have you hold one of these alchemists. See if we can get that. I saw them. I made his will save, definitely. Not our frogs. We will rage, because we have 3 rounds of rage left, and we'll charge. There we go. Getting some good damage in. I think we can charge in on this guy. Yeah. Trish Beastcaller is going to fall some more beasts, I think. Have her summon in dog. Dog's going. We'll throw a magic missile over at this dude. Now finish him off. Finish that guy off. Look at those froggies go. We're probably gonna be resting soon, so we will throw some magic missiles out.
Go on.
Let him charge across over here. Lindsay is going to scream. No, can't scream there. Maybe we just not this dude. Nice, and he's dazed. So he's not gonna be doing anything next turn. Gonna have him be recharging every turn as he can. Have the bear move up and swing.
I'll loot your corpse.
Trish, move up and swing at that guy. And our summons might finish us off. Him off, which just leaves this one kobold, this poor, poor kobold who knows no better and is surrounded by frogs, dogs, and mites. And there he goes. We just had to wait for one of them to go that about to.
So it's come to this.
That guy. Like that got pretty much everyone else. Okay. And we're good to keep going. Hey, thanks for joining us. We're playing some Pathfinder, exploring our kingdom. We've got about 30 days before we have to be back at the Bald Hilltop for the curse. So we're trying to get everything on this side of the river taken care of. We'll probably turn around the Verdant Chambers and head back. That's our goal. We'll go ahead and connect this, because that's probably where it's going to be. We don't own this region, so we're not going to be able to claim any of this yet. We'll just keep traveling. We've spotted enemies. Fight!
Careful now.
Find out where these enemies are. I've got some more kobolds.
Everything has a price.
Some in there that we can do.
Macritium Turinos. Macritium Turinos.
Something's wrong with the spell here.
Magritium Turinos.
We'll turn into a leopard on our turn. We've got an alchemist apprentice. We're gonna see if we
serves
can
you right.
Take him out first. Let's go for a magic missile on him, I think. Nice, I got him. Alright, so what else do we have? We have Spark Shaman, Kobold, a Sentry Veteran, and an Archer. So I think our next best option is to get a charge on this Spark Shaman. Get some good damage on him. Amiri's gonna use her last round of Rage. We will throw... No, we're gonna throw a Heavenly Fire. Nope, can't reach him with that. Can you shoot him?
Repent!
Oh no, this was a surprise round, so we aren't able to do that either. Charge in on the kobold. Take him out. Now
you
we can
deserved
shoot
him. It.
Finish him off. That'll be her turn. We're going to turn into a leopard. And then we're gonna come running up over this way. Now we can go to either side that we need to. I don't think we're gonna need to go to that side though. I think that side's gonna be under control. Finish him off, so now Amiri and this Heliodon go after him. We're gonna let Amiri go first, so that the Smilodon can get all of his attacks. Amiri is currently fatigued.
Bring it!
Oh, he still isn't gonna be able to get all the attacks. Moving too far. Yeah.
Go on.
That'll finish him off, and now we just finish off this. Select a loot. And that's it. That's that. We're good to keep on moving. Getting ready to
may we have a moment
rest.
Of respite?
We're gonna wait for Amiri to rest as well.
I'm hungry. When we
there
stop.
We go. So now we can just kind of venture over to the bandit camp and rest. Don't have a book. Why don't we do that? Not perfect, but it'll at least have someone in every position.
I feel I've spent a dozen years in a cold dungeon without a single ray of light.
You're making my jaw hurt. I wonder, is it laughter or disgust?
They don't seem to be on the best of terms. Those two don't. And now we'll enter the bandit camp and see what's going on there. Let's go
Here
ahead
I
and
am.
Have Amiri cast
see.
A bless spell. That'll last us 5 minutes.
The way seems clear.
Hey, you're all leaving some for me, right? Just stand, look out, you were told, like you were told. The man's voice carries the weight of his commands. He seems to be the leader of these bandits. His bushy beard is matted and remnants of the last day's meals are still evident in it. Quit your whining. We're all We'll always take care of our own, don't we? Says a disheveled, rotund woman with a round face. Ha! Right you are. When have we ever mistreated you, shorty? The short, ratty man, whose filthy strands of hair do little to obscure his prominent bald spot, doesn't even try to watch the road. His eyes are locked on the sight of his companions rummaging through their most recent haul and of obvious stolen loot. The bandit leader looks up and jumps with a start when he sees you, his sole eye wide in disbelief. Shorty, you ass! You were supposed to be watching the road! Shorty spins to face you, finally noticing your presence. Hey, someone's coming! Grab your blades! He yells belatedly. Hey, hold on, everyone, bandit leader says as he sheathes the sword he'd drawn just a moment ago. And Shorty, stop your foaming. Look here, this is our glorious Baroness herself. Come now, bow down, everyone, bow down. The bandit leader bows low, a smirk showing through his bushy beard. The rest of the bandits clumsily repeat the gesture, all except Shorty, who can only glance back and forth, unable to comprehend the situation. Who are you? What's going on here? Why, we're your loyal subjects. Honest bandits. The lot of us. The bandit leader, broad smile reveals a mouthful of rotted teeth. We'd been associating with the Stag Lord's band, but since you went and beat the stag out of them, we're left on our own. So now, you ought to take us in, Grace. We'd be even better with a strong leader. Wish to enter my service? Aye, your grace. We're ready and willing to serve. We'll take a pledge right now if you want. We'll kiss your boots, your ass, whatever you need. We're sick to death of hiding in the woods and sleeping in the dirt. Why be bandits when we could take from traitors legal-like? Collect taxes, he means, your grace, the rotund woman clarifies. All for the glory of your grace, of course, the bandit leader says with a grin. Hey, what are you saying? Geordi shakes his head in confusion. If that's the Baroness, the only job she'll have for us is noose tighteners. I say we cut her down and call it a day. Shut your trap, Shorty. I beg your pardon, your grace. Dumb as a doornail he is. Just joined our company but recently. Even the vilest villains deserve mercy, if they want to walk the path of redemption. However, I see no remorse in these people. Alright, I'll hire you, but only if you promise to straighten yourselves out and quit banditry. Leave these lands immediately. Believe you lose. Well, if we ever meet again, I'll kill you. Alright, I'll hire you. The barony has been lacking manpower recently, but all the taxes you collect will go to the barony treasury. Sure, I'll hire you if you deal with the shorty, that is. He's distasteful. No, I don't make deals with scoundrels. We're gonna start the barony off on a good foot. They're clearly not showing any remorse, as Tristan was saying. And they only deserve mercy if they decide to walk the path of redemption. They are not, so we're gonna kill them. These barons always think so high of themselves. Shorty spits on the ground. She robs folks worse than us, and then has the nerve to spew all this righteous crap at us. I say we gut him. Yeah! Get him. Here we go. Come on, Shorty. What you got for me? You're gonna have to do way better than that, my man.
Magnitium Turinos!
Poor Shorty doesn't even realize what he's getting himself into.
Tear them apart!
Oh, we don't need to outright.
Wretched things!
There goes Shorty.
You forced my hand.
We have Berta, Hendrick, and two regular bandits.
Yeah!
Let's have... try to hold person Hendrick. He's probably not gotten the best will save, but he still made it. Wow. He got almost exactly what he needed, and then he critted us. Holy crap.
Your death awaits.
We'll just go down. Maybe I should have raged. This guy seems like he might give us some trouble. Bone shaker him. I expected him to make the save, but it was just to get some damage on him. Take out this archer. One more. There we go. Throw a magic missile at this Hendrick guy. Got him down halfway, so not too shabby. Summons are doing their part and holding their own. Lindsay's gonna back up and fire that guy and miss. Okay, I would really appreciate him not continually critting me. Like, that would be the best thing in the world. I appreciate the frogs coming to our rescue. Should be able to get him in time.
Despicable!
Despicable! There you go, bear. We'll attack this guy. Yeah. Two more on this guy. Give me a crit. Not crit. That's not a crit. We'll throw another magic missile just to be sure. Got him. And that just leaves this bandit.
This is where I step in.
Just gonna take some heavy damage there.
Stab their backs.
And now the frog should be able to finish him off. We can get one hit. Yep. There we go. Bandit's taken care of. I will admit that their leader was a little bit tougher than I expected him to be. Gather all of these resources. Let's see. Get a few things. A heavy mace plus one. Two plus one bastard swords, plus one short bow, plus one short sword. Lindsay. Not sure which one's actually better.
I think the crossbow is, just a little bit. Oh, excuse me.
Plus one heavy. Doesn't. And my character can't use it. Okay. I think we're good as it. My character can use that shield, though. Be helpful. Boom. There we go. Got a little bit of an upgrade there. Just gonna kind of scout out the area, make sure we didn't miss anything. I'll walk around the whole place, and then I will throw up map and verify. Got it all.
How curious.
That's exactly why. Gotta find all those little bits of secret treasure. Throw up the map, and looks like we got it all.
Well.
Keep on going. And we'll just remember that next time, before we get into anything, we'll need to heal immediately. Something's happening in the kingdom. Too far away, though, so... it's just gonna have to wait. Go this way. Ruined Watchtower. We'll go to the Ruined Watchtower, and then we'll start to head back from there so that we can reach our Barony's lands and start to deal with the things there. Because I imagine it'll probably take us a couple days to get back. Then we can go up and kind of explore over towards Sorrowflow. And then we can head back down. Oh, we need to heal.
I'm listening.
Amiri and my character. Let's throw a cure mod.
Turinos.
Just letting the interest.
We're okay with the healing spells right now. I'm just concerned that it might not be that way forever. Grass has sprouted between the cobbles of the ancient road. We can come and venture off over this way first. Just make sure we get the map cleared so we're not having to backtrack a whole lot of stuff.
Precisely.
It looks like that's actually all that there is there. Okay. Oh, there's something to loot. What is it? Some rubble. We got a Torag pendant. A pendant of Torag.
That's easy.
I'm up here, looking around.
Quiet footsteps.
Lot going on here. Got natural armor amulet. Be nice. Not here to have a whole lot happening. Back down and around. There are some times where you have to come back to locations after you first visit them. This might be one of them. There might just not
the
be
way
anything
seems
here currently.
Clear.
We haven't progressed far enough in the story for whatever spawn here.
You
here.
Cannot stand against me.
Got some bandits though. So we can take them out. That was rude. Let's take
serves
out the alchemist.
You right.
Or at least try to take out the alchemist. Okay. Miri will let her charge this bandit.
That?
She spotted that. And then we'll have this guy charge the alchemist. Take him out. And now we're down to just the two bandits.
Cover me!
That'll finish him. We'll throw a ray of frost down lane. Nothing happened really, but
I'll try to make this swift.
There we go. Good solid damage in there.
Careful now.
Got a plus one bladed sword.
Anything else?
Lock the lock by Lindsay. Grab some mushroom. And continue on exploring.
I shall end this suffering.
Group. ferocious. That was not necessary.
You deserved it.
Let her cast herself. That way next turn she can basically guarantee to hold him, so now we only have to do a two. And hopefully this will get him. Yep, so now we only have to deal with the one. And we will delay until after this one, so that he runs up to us. And now we finish him off, which will just leave us with the one that's being held.
So it's come to this.
Should be a relatively... Yep, there we go.
Quiet footsteps.
You see that?
I do see that. Not only that, but I got
precisely.
It.
Precisely.
Someone over there. Some wolves surrounding him, it looks like. We'll have to venture over there to try to help him. Ability check that we can go down. Yeah, we can hit up this area and then kind of make our way back up and around and finish off up at the corner. Yeah.
That was easy.
Easy.
It's just not my lucky day.
What'd she need? The 21. She had a plus 13. What does... she has a plus 11. Okay, so we can get her up to a plus 14 if we use song and guidance. Is there a way that we can get her higher?
She already has a dexterity belt.
I don't think she can get any higher, so we could let her drink this. That would reduce her size so she'd do less damage in the next fight, but she would gain a bonus to her dexterity. That'd get her up to a 13, 14, 15. That's gonna be probably the best bet that we've got. I'm thinking about it. Everyone has amulet. Okay, so let's do that. Amiri, drink the potion of a person. That gets her up to a 17 there. Gets her up to a 12.
You have my attention.
With guidance. Be at a plus 13.
Adventures call to them.
Share your will.
Okay, she'll be at plus 14 because of this. So.
I always have the upper hand.
What you want?
Let's see if we can do it.
And Lindsay was called for.
Won't work.
Nope. Rolled a two. I don't think. Yeah. Neither one of them can try again. We'll have to wait for us to level up. We'll be back here eventually, and we can try it again then.
That's easy.
It'll stay shown up on our map. So. I'm sure it wasn't anything overly important.
Your death awaits. I'll loot your corpse.
Bring it!
Repent!
Any last wishes?
Got that one before you could attack. That's what we were aiming for. Now we'll finish this one off. There we go. And then we'll throw a ray of frost over here. One damage, and we'll finish it off. There we go. Now we can try to talk to these people up here. Alright. You hear a voice from somewhere above you. You there! Help us! A man wearing simple clothes waves to you from top massive rock. Hunters, we are! Hunters, we are! We were camping in the woods and suddenly we were up here. Some weird magics or something, I guess. For God's sake, help us! How'd you get up there? No clue. We were heading off to sleep when a dream came over us. A bright one, too. All three of us were in the river, and the current was sweeping us away. The trees on the shore were too high up to the sky. I tell ya. And the clouds above were like mountains. We went over a waterfall and hurtled down. Next I knew, we were up here on the rock, wet like drowned rats. I've never seen anything like it, and I hope I never have to again. How many of you are there? Is there anyone wounded? We're just two. I'm mostly good, thank you, Aristil. Lynel here, though, she came down pretty hard. She's got some broken ribs, can hardly breathe. As for Dolden, I think he's dead. I can only see his feet sticking out of the rock. There's some dwarf corpse up here, too. I guess he got up here the same way we did. So we can try to rescue him if we want. Try to catch you, but please be careful. Try to catch him after. Jump, we'll catch you. How much is help worth? We'll just catch him. We should probably be A-okay. We did do a lot of lawful good stuff, and we're trying to remain neutral, though. So maybe if we want to balance out, the neutral evil would be how much is health worth, and then chaotic good. So that'll balance out the lawful and the good that we've kind of been doing. Let's do that. How much is health worth? I found this funny thing on the corpse up here. It looks valuable. You save us, it's yours. Fair enough. Alright. Jump. We'll try to catch you. You manage to get a cloak stretched taut and try to catch the hunters. The man above pushes his friend down first, then jumps himself. You catch them both without any trouble. The hunter hands you a gilded metal cog. My word's as good as gold. Here's what's promised. Thank you for your help. Digging through his pockets, the hunter pulls out a small purse. Take this too. Lynel and me owe you our lives after all. Got some extra gold too. Like it. A pair of legs sticks out from the boulder's surface. And the dead dwarf. If Lynel has anything to say. Thank you. Would help me. Everything will be fine now. Okay.
The way seems clear.
Just saying thanks again. Open it. Oh, a troll. He's got protection from fire, so we're gonna have to use acid to get rid of his regeneration. So fire removes regeneration, acid removes it, but he's protected from fire, so we'll have to use acid, it looks like. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and cast Bless again. Sentence. Plus 2 actual bonus. It also deals 2d6 damage. Bane weapon exceeds against certain foes. Against a designated foe, the weapon. So, what is this? Weapon. I don't know which foe that helps. Doesn't tell me which bow.
Done with waiting.
Do I pick it when I use it? It's not. I guess it just helps in general. Okay. Yeah, she'll do that. And then she'll rage.
Anything is possible.
Is he gonna take a shot? This is the first troll we've actually encountered. Level 9.
I wish there was another way.
Get a charge in.
Tear them apart!
Oh, there's several trolls. Okay, move up here, I guess. All allies went 30. Okay, so we're gonna move up here, and then we'll cast protection from alignment, because he's evil, and a kobold's also gonna be evil, so. But we'll do. And we will go ahead and start getting some summoning going. Drop 1d3 frogs. I can't because it's a surprise round. Not going to do that. Not yet.
So, Taya.
Later we'll save. Alright, Amiri. There we go. Get that crit in. Oh god, that did like no damage to him. Okay, alright, Amiri, calm down. Let's make sure we prevent the damage dealing. That's not gonna really help us, I don't think. We're just gonna summon some frogs. A couple frogs. We're just gonna focus. See if we can get him low or down, either or. There we go. Okay, so we got him. So now we just got two more. That guy. Okay, these guys seem like they're much easier, so.
I'm alright.
We're gonna come over here. And these guys are not immune. So we can just burning hands to get both of them.
Go on.
Oh, never mind. Try to kill him.
Yes.
We need to get some kind of fire damage on that one to prevent him from healing. But I think what I'm gonna do is not letting me put it in between them. I guess I have to target. Oh. Right there. Okay, it's gonna get Amiri too.
Learn how to use it first.
Oh, no, I have to target one. Alright, so we're gonna target the one that we hurt. Just make sure he doesn't heal. He took a few fire points, so that's good enough for us. And then we'll move up.
Advance!
On. So he's not healing, that's the big thing. That was gonna be. And I only do earth. Oh no, I can use that one. Okay, so I think we've got this under in the bag, but we'll just know that I can shape into a fire elemental, which will help us with trolls later. But for now, I think we can get by just summoning smites.
Magritium Turinos.
But we will know that we can do that later, which will help us in the future. guys. This should have been a count. Yep. And then I'm gonna hit him close. Amiri might. Yeah, okay. So now all we have to do is make sure that we get some fire damage on him. It shouldn't be too hard. We aren't too worried about the summons, so I'll tell you what, we're just going to make sure we get it a little bit. Those aren't even there yet, I don't think. Yeah, see, they didn't take damage, so we're good. Now we just have the kobold.
This is where I step in.
But is hopefully going to die relatively quickly. Oh yeah. Can we just get charging on him? No, can't. Okay, we're just gonna move up then. Kind of off to the side so that we don't get in the way of anyone. And then one of these guys might finish him off. Yep, there we go. Alright. Doing pretty good. Let's loot these guys and keep on looking around. That guy as well. Still got our buffs right now for another 30 seconds, so if we get into a fight, this wouldn't be a bad time to do that. We saw something, I'm not sure what. We'll catch it on the way back.
Quiet footsteps. They should have known better.
We just kind of like walked right up on her.
Stab their backs.
Serves you right.
Wretched things.
You forced my hand.
Tear them apart!
How was that? Oh, is there more? There's all of her friends then. Over this way? Perhaps? Oh, right there. Okay. Charge him, my friend. And we missed. Oh. Oh, they were hiding. Back up 5 feet out of combat. We're gonna shoot at her. For a critical hit, that was a sneak attack. That really didn't do a whole lot.
Despicable.
We're actually gonna let this guy. You know, we'll just.
I'll try to make this swift.
Okay, so it looks like they're all kind of over that way.
They go
run up
down!
And swing at him and miss. I will throw up a summon right there. I think having one in this fight will help us, but I don't want to throw anything too high level. And you know what? I think we'll be able to finish these two off. We got two more. Yep. Now it's just that guy. So probably didn't even need the summon after all. I overestimated these guys, their damage potential.
Any last wishes?
Her kind of run up over this way.
What a surprise.
Oh, she spotted a trap. Okay. Charge here? No. So he's just gonna run up. He'll run behind so he's not blocking any charges that need to happen. So that way he can also provide like a flank.
So it's come to this.
Amiri can't charge.
Cover me!
Yeah, he's gonna get some damage in. Must have been an orc. Because orcs have the ability to stay alive one more round after they go to zero or lower. Probably what it was. Alright, don't fail us, Lindsay.
Applause, please.
One gold. It was all just a bandit trap. how are we doing? Oh, we got some herbs back up here. That we can... I'll probably go ahead. We're not going to be able to get that because that was the locked chest. I'll say let's go ahead and come down here and get this that we missed, and then we can come over and then make our way up. Orban Helmet Guard. That was a good one to get.
Precisely.
That's a lot of wolves. A lot of wolfies. We can rage again. Let's go ahead and do that.
Bring it!
Yeah, there we go. And she'll kind of move up over.
This is where I stop there. It.
That's a pretty good hit. Yeah. No charge, but we can move up and attack. Two alpha wolves. Okay. Let's go with. Summon 1d3 frogs? No. Not gonna be able to because we're gonna have to. That's okay. We're gonna move up over here so we're out of Amiri's way when she needs to charge in. Doesn't look like she's gonna get to charge in.
Advance!
Okay, never mind. She'll get to charge in. I just don't know if she's gonna be able to because
Repent.
Of the people being in her way. We'll have to see. Can Amiri charge? Yeah, she can. Get some of those damage
Serves
on her.
You right.
And then... see if we can finish that one off. Oh, there we go. There we go. One more. Yeah, there we go. Finished it off. I don't have a way of holding the animal, but it's just
Your
the one.
Your death awaits.
Attack. Did I get knocked down?
Unworthy.
I'm just gonna go ahead and swing. I don't really think there's any casting spells. Just the one wolf left.
Tear them apart!
Still got all of our major damage dealers coming up.
You deserved
Amiri,
it.
Amiri, Lindsay, and the Smilodon. One more. Yeah, there we go. One hand axe. Amiri has 50 seconds left on her fatigue. I'm thinking
Quiet
maybe
footsteps.
We just wait the last 40 seconds or so and then tackle this next fight right up here. No point in her being injured any more than she already
just
is.
Letting the
There's
intro.
No point in her being penalized more than she already
Confide
is.
Confide in me.
Some wargs and they're gonna be a little bit tougher. Level 7. Hopefully there's not too many of them back there. Okay, what are we looking at? 12 seconds?
I will not be trifled
give me
with.
Time to get some summons up.
Magritium Turino.
I'm listening.
Dawnflower, guide my hand.
Okay, so well, that's actually a lot of work. Okay. So she'll be fatigued for this round. But then next round she won't be. Be okay after that round. Oh god, that's actually a lot of hit points that we have to chew through. Okay, so maybe instead we just cast a protection from evil because wargs are evil.
Wash.
Right. So we got the protection from evil up, and then. That'll probably be it with all. Alright, Lindsay, you're gonna attack the one that. One of the ones that has not gone yet. Well, none of them are flat footed, so. I don't think
Any
it really
last
matters.
Wishes?
We're going to throw up another summon.
Magnesium Turinos!
Now they're all entering the initiative order, so next turn they'll come up. We're gonna actually delay until after these guys. Just so that we can hopefully get them to come to us. Yep, just like that. They're evil, so we'll try this. Miss. Good news is there's only one that can really attack our party right now. That's gonna really help us out. Okay, so we got his Barbarian Rage temporary hit points. This. Throw up. This is gonna be a relatively difficult fight because they're all level 7 technically, so we're gonna get a good bit of help here. They're doing a good bit of damage too. Not quite enough to finish off everyone, but still a good bit. Don't get me wrong, we do a good bit of damage too, but we just want to be able to move up so that Amiri can come around and swing as well if he's not dead.
Bring it!
There we go. Now Triss. We're gonna try this again. There we go. Finish him off. Just kind of move up in there. Now these guys will go. They'll finish that frog off. The key here is that they are attacking our summons instead of us. And if we can get them kind of weakened enough. We can get it down to like one or two of them before our summons go away, then I think we're gonna be okay. Problem is, they're killing those guys like right out the gates.
This is where I step in.
Yeah, just delay. Wait and see how things go. We are getting some damage in there. That's good. Let's play. Delay. Paladon. We can have kind of move up and over here. Up there. Okay, so he's getting some good damage there. The bear we're gonna let go after Amiri. Amiri can move up into here.
Tear them apart!
Good damage there. And now the bear should be able to finish him off. Yep, there we go. So we're able to finish off one each round. We just have to be able to last for those rounds. So that's our goal right now. Nice, we got some good damage there. That's one that these frogs have already kind of been going after, so that's good. We're gonna go in wild shape into a leopard. And then we're gonna cast the rest of it. Okay, so frog's dead there. That means Amiri can shift around, bear can shift up, and leopard can come in. So we're gonna see if we can clear out this guy next. So he's already at about half health, and this one's already started to take some damage, so good with that.
serves you right.
Got some damage on him. Awesome. Alright, we're gonna shift over into our 5 foot. Up this way. Attack me. One more. There we go. Okay. Now we're looking like we're in a better position. Because Amiri, she only gets one attack.
They go down!
Up over here. And swim there. Hey! The bear, since he's not going to be able to get multiple attacks this turn, he can move further. Fire at that guy who hasn't been hit by this yet. And the good thing about this is just an additional ability. It doesn't, it's not really a spell for us. We can cast all of those at these guys. Alright. No, it doesn't. I thought for a second we might have gotten a, like, pounce. Yeah, but we don't. Alright, so we're just gonna move up and bite claw.
This won't kill me.
Okay, so he did finally attack her, but that's okay. Okay, awesome. See if Lindsay
you
can finish him off.
It.
And now we just have to try to take him out this turn. Frog misses. Nice. Very good. Very good. So we managed to kill those 4 wargs. We did have to use a lot of our spells and stuff, so we're probably going to be looking at resting relatively soon. But overall, did very well in that instant. So that was a tougher fight. A little bit of a tougher fight. Thanks for joining us. We're currently making our way through the Ruined Watchtower, Pathfinder Kingmaker. Hope everyone who is watching is having a good day so far. I was not wanting to engage with the fight yet. Okay. I am still in a state, so... we'll go after this guy. Yeah! Lindsay, we'll have you go after him. See if we can take your caster out of the fight. Amiri, you don't have any more rage, so let's just, let's get you engaged with their caster, so if he tries to do anything, you can cast at him. We'll have you move up over here, though. That way you can kind of engage with both of these. And we'll let your Smilodon go after that one. Alright, bear. Where's the bear going? Bear can go on the caster as well. We'll have the bear actually move around the back of the caster. Throw some magic missiles at somebody. Let's throw it at this guy. We're spreading damage out a little bit right now, which isn't the best thing, but this round we should be able to take out most of everyone, if not everyone, so we should be okay. We'll attack him. We'll sneak up there. Yep. Get a little bit of movement. Yep. Now, get some items there. Bear should be finished off. Yeah, just kill them all. That's the goal. How's it going, John? Are they neutral? Yeah, they're neutral. That's why I can't use that ability. throw another magic missile at him. That'll finish him off. Go. Did not finish him off. Okay.
Wretched thing.
She finished them off. Oh, yeah, there we go. That is not what I wanted to do, Lindsay. Okay, well, we'll move you that way. So mean. Why are you hurting my kitty cat like that? Oh, I'm slowed. I was wondering what was going on. I'm like, what is going on? Why am I not moving? So slow. Not good. Okay.
Go on.
Despicable.
Okay. Slowed or not, we managed to get him. Okay, and then there was a chest over here. Please get it.
Applause, please.
We got a shard of a knight's bracer.
How may I?
We're gonna heal up some.
Turinos.
Adventures call to them.
Take care of the rest, I think. Esme, Axe, yes.
Request.
Okay.
What's that?
Please don't make this explode, Lindsay.
Anything else?
Plus one Falcata. Probably sell that. I don't think any of us are going to use Falcatas, though. Hey, thanks for joining us, guys. We're currently making our way through this little map area. Oh, those are not... Okay. Hope everyone's having a good day so far. Appreciate you jumping in and watching the stream. You see three peasants circling an ancient oak as they talk loudly among themselves. I found it! What? Where? Show us! Nay, wasn't nothing. Just thought I did. Damned stump. Man hits the trunk of the tree with his fist, then winces and massages his hand. Well, put your backs into it. I can smell the gold. I can. Who are you? What's happening here? The men jump up and press their backs to the oak's massive trunk. They never take their eyes off you as they lean towards each other, whispering. You barely catch the words Baroness and treasure. We're from the village nearby, my lady, the bravest of them answers, and the others nod along. We want to cut this here tree, see? Winter's not far off, you know. Gonna need some wood, second man adds. And with this much, we maybe could build a boat, too. Cut it out, she heard us, the third one mutters, a quiver in his voice. So much for our gold. You're not in trouble, just tell me everything. Yeah, just tell me. I probably don't even care about the gold. In all honesty, it's probably not that much. Villager glances at his sullen companions. We're searching for gold here, m'lady. A traveling bard spent the night in our village. Told us tales about big fights and barbarians, the chieftains who led their hordes here long ago. At the end, he said he knew where the barbarian chieftains buried. At the end, he said he knew where the barbarian chieftains buried. Promised he could show us. We paid him 2 gold. He wanted 3, but we could only gather 2. He told us anyway, though. Are you safe? I remember their customs correctly. Ugh, that's gonna be a 14 on the die. Why aren't you worried about wandering around these lands? Dangerous out here. Maybe there's some enchantment beneath the tree? The old oak bears no enchantment. This doesn't exclude the possibility that treasure is there. It may simply be hidden too deep, or perhaps the treasure isn't magical in nature. We'll see if we can pass this check. Hey, there we go. As you recall, there were barbarian tribes that rode across these lands long ago. Moreover, they buried their chieftain in Cairns, where with all their earthly possessions. However, all of the Nong Karns... Is it Karns, like, pronounced C-A-R-N-S, or is it Cairns? Cairns? I don't know, I never know how to pronounce that word. Far to the east, or northwest. So it's either all the way over near Varnhold, or up in Glenborn. Not here, in other words. The villager impatiently awaits your reply. Truth is, the bard lied to you. George's not here, I know where it is. Point a random location on that. I'm too busy to dig it out myself. Decisions. Why aren't you worried about wandering these lands? It's dangerous out here. We've lived here all our lives around here, Malay. Got nothing to be scared of. Meet a kobold, we hit him hard. If we meet a wolf, we climb a tree. And if a troll comes around, we run as fast as we can. I mean, you know, fair enough. Charged bandits, we're not afraid of them. They don't cross us because we don't have two coins to scrape together. You know, fair enough. We've been doing a lot of, like, lawful and good stuff, and we're not wanting to kind of have a lawful good kingdom, so we're going to throw a little chaos into the mix. We're going to bluff them. The bard lied to you. The treasure's not here. I do know where it really is, and I'll point it to him on the map. Oh, we failed. We'll still fell the tree and dig here, m'lady, since we've already started. Fair enough. Shame on you. Just one misfortune, and you're ready to give up? Where is your wanderlust? Your taste for adventure? Where is your faith in your lucky star that will lead you towards a great fortune? Huh? These were some mighty words. Here's the bard art for you. Even though you understand she's bullshitting you, the way she does, it makes you want to believe. How do you know it's bull? Not just some bard from a tavern. It's her grace's own bard. Why would our baroness lie to us? Good thing our baroness is so kind. Alec, get your gold here. We want to thank m'lady. Apparently, I got some gold coins. The gold coins that they couldn't scrape together. Thank you, m'lady. We'll give you your share as soon as we find the treasure. The villagers newly inspired marched eagerly in the direction you indicated. The huge centuries-old oak. It is a real colossus. Okay. But I guess they ended up going off search for that treasure anyway, even though I failed the check. Okay. We have looped all the way back around here. Got another Torag's pendant. So we could try to climb the ancient stairs, or we could probably just loop around, for being honest. We'll give climbing a shot. And we failed. Try it again.
That was easy.
Hey, there we go. Oh. It's awkward. Hi, spiders. We were just leaving.
This is where I step in.
We were just leaving. Okay, you don't have to come over here. Okay, now. Hold up. That was rude. I was uncalled for. If only I had like a fireball or something like that. Let's go for this dude.
They go down!
Two attacks on this guy to finish him off. One. Two! Yeah, there we go. Three attacks on that guy. Yeah, missed with a bunch of them. Three attacks on that guy. One. Two hits. Okay, I'll take it. Why are there more? Why are there always more? Start playing our music. Okay, please stop attacking me. I would greatly appreciate it. Ba-bum-bum-bum. Bone shaker that guy. Go ahead and try to finish that guy. One, two, three. There we go. See if we can finish him off. There we go. Two more attacks on this guy? Nope, on this one. We will have the bear move up kind of in the middle of these guys so that he can attack both. And third one of this guy. Hey, now Lindsay serves finishes him right. off. Nope, she missed it. That was absolutely uncalled for.
Right here, my friend.
Magritium Turinois.
Poor kitty. Just trying to do right by him.
Turinos.
Find him some nice food.
I wrote it like I saw it.
Esme, state your desire.
Tashani Savitur. Tashani Savitur.
And Lindsay was called for.
Esme, Axe. Yes.
Alright, and I think I'm out of spells now. Do I have access to restoration? Question. Oh yeah, I do. Okay. Have I already used my bonded holy symbol?
Share
today?
Your troubles.
I have not. Let's see if we can deal some dexterity damage back. Hey, three back. Now we're good. No dexterity damage anymore. All right, moving on. All right. Once long ago, a sturdy watchtower rose above the forest, ready to signal an enemy's approach, day or night. Now the ancient moss-covered stone were crumbling, and birds rather than warriors inhabited the place. The ground floor had been long looted, but there still seemed to be some furniture left on what remained of the upper floor. A rotted table, an uneven chair, and a small, but seemingly robust chest. Sadly, the stairs leading up to the leading up had collapsed long ago. I had to take our time and make a sturdy ladder. Fortunately, there were plenty of material. Tried climbing up. I mean, a four is going to fail it, but that's it. Jethal deftly climbed the stone, even as they crumbled beneath her feet. On the next floor, she found what must have been a living room centuries ago. There were even the remnants of a decomposed floor mat. The chest was heavy, but it didn't take Jethal much effort to push it to the ledge and drop it down. The chest fell to the stone floor with a loud thud, a huge cloud of dust rising around it. The wood had darkened over the years of exposure to the sun and the rain. The metal siding had grown a layer of rust, and the decorative carvings on the lid were barely discernible. Even so, the chest itself was robust and secure as the day it was made by some unknown dwarven master, and of course, it was still locked. So we searched for a key among the ruins. That's a DC 10. Trickery. We tried picking the lock. Just strength. We'll look for a key first. Hey, there we go. The search turned out to be a surprising success. We found a key in a small niche that had been covered with rubble. Despite its age, the dwarven lock was still operational. We turned the key and the chest lid opened with a shrill creak. Inside, we found simple possessions of a dwarven warrior who must have once stationed at the tower. Battle gear consisting of chainmail, a helmet, a shield, and an axe. A pair of torn traveling boots and metal tankard the size of a small bucket. A pipe and a full pouch of tobacco, which had petrified over the years. And lastly, a peculiar little thing. A complex red metal cog. Okay, got a metal cog. Got the soot blackened apron, the red cog, and of course all of the other stuff. Yeah. All right, what's up here? The remnants of a cobbled road are barely visible. Oh god, that's long. Perchant words written every morning. I wake up to the world. Eyes. I'm not going to go through and read all this. At any point in time, if you want to, I do put the videos up on YouTube. You can go through and kind of pause the video as it scrolls up and down. I believe it was just talking about kind of the watch of one of the old people here. Unlike the time-worn watchtower, the statue of Torag is in perfect condition. The dwarven god's face has a stern look, almost accusatory, when combined with surrounding devastation. Let's leave for a second, so I can just go back to it. And what we're gonna do?
Speak.
We're gonna cast guidance.
Anything is possible.
And we're gonna inspire confidence to give a plus. There we go. We're up to a 17. So we're gonna examine the statue. Dwarven artisans are famous for installing clever hidden mechanisms in their works. You discover a hidden panel with a niche above it. In the niche, a set of jagged grooves adorned with arcane symbols seems to be connected to something deeper inside the statue. It seems that access to Torag's treasures will require the missing cogs. Put 3 cogs into the mechanism. I did just get some cogs. I don't feel like trying to open it would be the best way. We're going to try to put some cogs in. You have all 3 cogs, but you're not sure how they fit, how to fit them in the mechanism. Maybe the arcane markings inside are a clue. We only need 5, so... Sure. Nice. The markings seem vaguely familiar. Raking through your memory, you realize they're all well-known alchemical symbols, though in an ancient dwarven script. The symbol for tin seems to be designed for the white cog, representing tin smiths. Iron must mean the red cog for blacksmiths, and while gold is for the gold cog, and goldsmiths. Having placed all the cogs properly, you see they can now rotate. You rotate the cogs and hear a rumbling noise. The statue, following a loud click, the panel opens, revealing the treasure stored within. Hey! That's what we're talking about. Lindsay.
Just letting the ink dry.
Okay. I don't think anyone wears heavy armor, so... The plate mill's not going to really do a whole lot of good for us. At least not outright. Full plate. I don't think anyone can do that. Yeah, no. But the belt will be useful. I'll probably throw that on my character once she's no longer a leopard. What... light crossbow. We'll give the +1 heavy crossbow to him. And I think that's all for now. He doesn't have a necklace. We can give the natural armor +1 necklace. But I think everyone has a cloak at least. Yeah. Okay. Great. Egg statue. Mushrooms! It's going pretty good. How's it going? thanks for joining us. Those that are just joining us. Ooh, troll. It's going a little less good now that there's a troll here, because I'm out of spells. But overall, well, it's going pretty good. Nothing crazy.
Something bothering you?
I at
what
least have acid splash, so that's
what
good.
What you want? Share your will.
Yeah, I don't have a lot of spells left.
The undead is such a frivolous term. I prefer immortal, eternal, everlasting.
Adventures call to
right,
that.
Lindsay, fire away.
Scared? You
yeah, that
should
sneak
be.
Attack. What happened to your sixth person? I'm just not using a sixth person right now because I have it where only the party gets experience, and I'm saving that slot for Ekandeyu. So I don't want to necessarily give any unneeded experience to any of the other people. But I'm just making my life difficult, basically. I don't actually do a whole lot of damage, so I'm just going to kind of move up. Amiri and the Smiling Monster are the ones that do a lot of damage. Oh, we have Trollhounds. Excellent. Just what I was wanting. Additional fight. Technically, yes, they will level a little bit faster, because they won't be splitting all of the experience between everyone. So technically, they will level faster. It won't be a whole lot faster, but it will be a little bit.
You deserved it.
I'm not doing it wrong. The spell is flawed.
Go get him. Splash his way. Apparently we just barely killed him.
Any last wishes?
There we go. Kerblam. That's gonna make it hard to come back from.
Bring it! Look at me, Gorum!
Look at her, Gorum. We're gonna throw an acid splash at this guy downrange. And then charge him with this guy. And easy peasy. All done. Although I don't know if I'd say easy peasy. That could have easily gone the other way. Couple of bad hit rolls, and I could have been in
you
trouble
see that?
There, so.
Applause, please.
Applause. Got a Dwarven Helm Shard again. So what we'll probably do is, after we finish exploring this area and clearing it out, we're going to go back.
And then our leader charged forwards.
To,
hey, wait for me.
Go back to our settlement and do a little bit of the settlement stuff there. Let's turn into a fire elmo, I think, to help with the troll hound. That'll help a little bit with the troll hound's regeneration. Then we'll just move on up.
I'll try to make this swift.
Let's get a charge all the way down here. Oh, and a crit to kill off the wolf.
A
unworthy.
This is where I stand.
Yep, there we go. We'll have him run up over there. And Amiri can't get a charge off, so she's
gonna run
them
up apart!
And attack. Alright, there we go. We got some fire damage on him, so he's not gonna be regenerating this turn.
So it's come to this.
I'll kill him.
Repent!
And this should take care of him. Yep, there we go. They're just moving on along.
What's that?
Finding some gold. We'll make sure there's nothing that we need to spot over here as well. So. Nope, I think we're good. I think that clears out pretty much this whole place. Really, the only thing that we missed was this, but that's because we failed to pick the lock, so we'll have to come back about half a level to retry. That's okay. We'll be back here at some point anyway, I think, because I think there's going to be a quest related to it. I don't precisely remember, but we'll make a note that we need to come back to here. Alright, so we're going to head up back towards our lands. We've still got a good little while before the curse, but we've got a few other things that we have to take care of, like going over to the ruins up here. So if we make our way back to our lands, that'll just make it a little bit simpler. We've gotten a good bit of explored in this area.
Resting would be nice, don't you
we'll
think?
We'll stop and rest. So the only places that we haven't really explored are down in this kind of southern Gnarl Marches area, and then over in the Dire Gnarl Marches, which, to be fair, the Dire Gnarl Marches are probably pushing the upper end of our level. We'll probably have to gain a level or two before we go into there. But the next expedition, we'll just come straight over to here, and we'll try exploring this area. We're gonna go back and take care of some kingdom stuff.
Stay away from me, you spook! I'll tear off your hands before you can blink!
You flatter yourself. I've no interest in primitive boneheads.
So one thing that we're trying to decide if we want to do, we currently are going through the sorcerer route here because we were going to do like a bunch of like summoning and stuff. When it occurred to me that I could do the same thing with a cleric route, I would just have to prepare the summon spells, but that would also allow her to heal herself in the long run. So we're trying to decide if we want to stick with the sorcerer. Which will give us a little bit more damage potential, I think, or if we want to go with the cleric route, which is going to help us manage the healing of her, because she cannot heal from normal cure wound stuff, because she's undead. So we're trying to decide that. What do you think, Jonathan? We still have a, Harem has a request, okay. Harem wants to. We still have a fairly free... Do we not do anything right now? Harem has to do that. Gongar could pillage, but we don't want to pillage the people. Harem has to do that. We don't have an advisor for that. Yeah, I guess we're just waiting for Carol. Oh, it's mostly when dealing with Jethal, who is the undead girl in our party. We're trying to figure out if we want to stick with the sorcerer route, which is going to give us probably a little bit more damage, or if we want to go with a cleric route, which will help keep her healed up, because she doesn't really, she can't benefit from the spells like the cure,
resting would
cure
be
light
nice,
and cure moderate
stuff,
because she's a undead. So trying to figure out if we need to respec her or not. We do still have one more free respec or retrain, so it's not going to be that big of an issue if we need to retrain her. And even then, I don't think it's incredibly expensive to do, even if we did run out of free ones. I think my biggest concern is I'm not sure we're going to have a big kind of semi-tank for the party, and she could potentially fill that role if we retrained her. But at the same time, we also don't have a major arcana. You don't think it's going to be that good?
My instincts dull when I'm tired. The way seems clear.
I feel like I need a little too much right now. The only other option that I was thinking about was we could just go with Harem instead. I just hate that he would have already missed out on a lot of the experience, or some of the experience. Let me just sell this real quick, because we don't need any of that. Let's see, what level? All right, we're like halfway through level 6. What level is Harem? So see, we could go with Harem, who's a destruction cleric. The biggest issue with him, is that he doesn't have a high enough charisma. In theory, yeah, technically. Sork is better for DPS. So what we currently have, we have our Sacred Huntsmaster, which Amiri's going to do some decent damage, and her pet's going to do decent damage. We also have Christian, which is going into a sorcerer cleric build that's kind of like a combination. Gizmo. So I guess we technically have a little bit of damage with Christian. He's just going to be mostly like fire-based damage. Then we have Lindsay, who's going to be kind of our buffer. She's going to buff us, being a bard. And we have my character, who is going to have some kind of like battlefield control-esque kind of feel. So we don't really have a strong tank. And we're also going to have Ekandeyu, who's going to be a ranged DPS. So we've got a ranged DPS, an arcanist-style DPS, semi-arcane. He's not full arcane. Melee DPS, buffer and debuffer, and then a little bit more battlefield control and summoner for like that. So we really don't have a tank, so I'm thinking maybe build her into one. Amiri's okay. She isn't going to be as good as she normally is as a tank because she's only going to have level 1 barbarian. She's still going to have a decent number of hit points, and she'll still have the like first level rage, like the level 1 rage, but she's not going to just be a big meat suit like she is in other playthroughs, and it's because we're getting the Sacred Huntmaster. So the whole thing with the Sacred Huntmaster is she's got not solo tactics, hunter tactics, where at level 3 she shares all of her tactic feats with her companion. So because of that, they're going to be really good kind of working together and doing extra damage that way. So she's going to be more of a kind of second row damage dealer. Not a primary damage dealer, not a primary tank, but kind of on that second row picking off foes wherever they are. I'm thinking what I'm probably going to do is maybe do like level 3 Inquisitor and then the rest Cleric, which will give her a little bit more tanky instead. I haven't completely figured out. Just kind of throwing out ideas. I just don't want to get too far into the build before making a decision.
Quiet footsteps.
Thanks for joining us, guys. We were just kind of talking about debating on how we want to build some of our companions. Harim looks embarrassed. He runs his fingers through his beard and clears his throat a few times. Then he speaks. I heard, not that important, but, well, he clears his throat again. I heard that an ancient trade road built by the dwarves of the Five Kings Mountain runs through these lands. I don't know what happened to them or where they went. Unforgiving time spares no one, but the road itself is still here, and possibly... not only the road. Harim holds his beard in his fist. Well, I have a request. If you find any dwarven runes in the area, I'd like to see them with my own eyes. Why do you ask this? Of course, if I find any dwarven runes, don't hear nothing. Alright, why ask this? Harim fiddles with his beard again. I shouldn't. Probably. But it's like a wound that's never healed. You know, it will only hurt more, but you still need to scratch it. Of course, it's foolish. Foolish and vain. But still, I wish to look at them. Okay, sure. I'll take you. Thank you. thank you. And he goes marching off. Take a look at our weapons. We're just gonna throw all these in here for now. We'll figure out what we want to do with them later. I'll sell them later. I'm just not gonna go through and do it now. Alright. So let's take a look. We might as well go ahead and level these guys up. There's no point in not doing that. I really don't feel like there's any reason to level him up as anything other than a cleric. None of the prestige classes really help him a whole lot. None of the arcane stuff helps. The only other things I could think would be either Inquisitor or Fighter, but I kind of feel like he'd just do good for a cleric, so we're going to take him the cleric route. We're definitely going to want perception, and I feel like religion just makes sense for a cleric, even though we have plenty of people that can do religion, so we're not going to really use him a whole lot anyway, so not like it matters. Mostly just wanting to make sure we can get him to the levels that we can bump up his ability so that he can get some bonuses on his kingdom-related stat. Alright, so if we go cleric, I don't know what spells the cleric's stuff is going to be. I worry about that a little later. Focus plus 1 8. Spell pin, kill soul. Spell ability. Let's just click next. Just click something, go next for a second. Let's take a look and see what these spells are. Alright, that's evocation. Wait, what spells is his destruction domain? Alright, so True Strike, Bone Shaker, Rage, Fear, Bone Shatter, Harm, Disintegrate, Horde, Wilting Tsunami. Chaos Domain. Spell, Freedom Movement, Acid Spray, Blast, Word of Chaos, Cloak of Chaos, Summon. Kind of all over the place. Touch infuses. Probably. He channels positive energy. Okay. So I'm thinking maybe take necromancy as a focus, because almost everything is destruction domain. Bone Shaker, Fear, Bone Shatter, Harm, Disintegrate, or Disintegrate might not be. Horrid Wilting, though. All of those are necromancy spells. Maybe focusing in necromancy with him. Like, see, I mean, necromancy there. I think the Cure Light is conjuration. Yeah. But I feel like just because of his domain stuff, it needs to be either evocation or necromancy. And I feel like necromancy is going to be the better option, because that's going to also affect the inflict and things like that. So we'll go with that. Cleric again. Bump up his wisdom, because we want to make sure that we're getting... we're going to want to make sure that we're getting his stat bonuses for his... Greater spell focus. That adds a plus. Yeah, I think we do that. And we might go into evocation after that, just to see how his spell list looks. Yeah, so he's like 2/3 of a level behind everyone right now. Isn't the best, but it is what it is. Abjuration, divination, abjuration, necromancy, abjuration, enchantment. So maybe abjuration's the way that we probably should have. There's not really a lot of offensive stuff that would require a DC for that, though. The only thing. Yeah, I'm thinking we just keep the necromancy. That's probably going to be fine. Firebelly, I guess, is abjuration. But that's the only one, so we'll keep it as is for him. Alright, Octavia's in an interesting position. She has level 1 in Rogue and level 2 in Wizard. They clearly want you to take her in the Arcane Trickster route, but I'm not sure I want to take her that route. If you don't take her in Wizard, then you're just losing out on too many good things, like all of your spell casting. That'll also help her out with that. If we want to fall back on the Arcane Trickster, we need 4 ranks in mobility and 4 in trickery, and we need sneak attack 2, 4 ranks in Arcana. That's actually something that we can get pretty quickly. So 4 ranks in mobility, 4 Trickery, 4 in Arcana, and we're going to bump up her Knowledge World just in case we want to take her somewhere. Then we simply choose any of her Maybe we go sense vitals with her. We do let her go the arcane tricks route. Throw web up in there. Okay. So we need a level 2 sneak attack, which we could get just by simply going accomplished sneak attacker at this level. And then we also get a wisdom bonus. Okay, so knowledge world, knowledge arcana, and throw the other points of perception. We need the accomplished sneak attacker. That's what we need. Oh, we don't get the wizard bonus. We need to... Oh. God, see, what would have been so much better for her if instead of the greater spell focus here, they just went spell focus, accomplished sneak attacker, and then at level 5 you could go into the multi-class, but... They really kind of mess you up with that. So we get this feat. And we just pick some more spells. We're going to need something like Acid Arrow, probably. Goes Transmutation Route. So I don't want to get any of these because they're going to be outdated relatively quickly. That's an enhancement bonus. So if you have the belt or the necklace or whatever, that enhancement bonus overrides this one. So... I don't like picking these up, so instead maybe we get something like Burning Arc and maybe we get Acid Arrow and Create Pit, and if we want to later on we can start to focus in things like Conjuration to give her higher DCs than that. Maybe we do that. Either way, we want something that can deal with trolls. So Acid Arrow will help us with that. And she should be... Yep, she's pretty much right where Harem is. And Ragongar is right where she is. And Valerie's right where she is. So. Charlie, come on now. Can't be up here if you're going to be doing all that. Alright, so we've got everyone leveled up how we're gonna have them for now. And then...
Precisely. Hey, yo,
we need to put all of those relics up. Go here. We're just gonna put all these up. Recipe into our books, and we're gonna go and take a look at key stuff. Met with a visitor. That's why we were out exploring, because we have nothing that we can do in here, so.
That's easy.
Do we want to take anything? We're going to want to take Harem with us in case we come across those dwarven runes. So let's grab some stuff to equip to him. I don't know if he has a cloak. Grab that. Intelligence won't really help him. Yeah, let's do that instead. The full plate that we found will be good for him. Yeah, full plate. Grab that back out, grab that. Protector of the Unjust, plus two resistance on saving throws, both AC and saving throw plus increase. Two against spells and abilities and attacks by good or lawful outsiders. Okay, well, that's not going to be overly helpful, but we'll take that. That's resistant. Okay, so that's not going to help him, though. The light hammer. Just trying to make sure that we get everything we need for Harem, because he's going to be coming with us for the time being. We are going to eventually run in. Dwarven. So, we'll take the flail. Plus one flail, so. And his weapon. So. Alright, I think that's got everything that we're gonna need for Harem. We don't need any of this stuff, so I think we're good. Leave, and we're gonna take him with us. Just because we're gonna end up running into some dwarven ruin, though. So. It's probably a good thing that we ended up leveling him up.
My instincts dull when I'm tired.
Let's go ahead and equip him. That. What is my just plus two dex give her plus two to all of that. He has plus two dex, plus two strength. Let's give her the dex. Give Amiri the strength. Lindsay has dex. Christian will give dex, and Aaron will give on. Okay. We can make use of some of these wands and such too while we're here. Bane. Pure light, we'll let him hold on to Fireball. Let her use shield. Cat's Grace. Freeze. Use True Strike. And the Fine Trap. Need that. Okay, that gets all of our wands taken care of. Almost all of them. That should be good there. Alright, so we're gonna head back off into the wilderness because we don't have anything we can do in our kingdom right now. Can't do anything at the Bald Hilltop until another 31 days and 5 hours. So we're gonna hold off on doing this Sorrow Flow, and we're gonna instead do the Dwarven look for the Dwarven Root out here. Start by going to this ruined watchtower again. I'm gonna wait for everyone to get tired and then we'll rest. Don't need to enter it because we just explored it. Gamble River. We'll keep going.
May we have a moment of respite?
Before we enter, we're gonna rest. We already know that this is gonna be a rough area. I needed to prepare spells for Harem.
Wouldn't you like to see the end of times? Serving Urgothoa could offer such an opportunity.
Okay.
Oh, the end of times will come with or without me. Why multiply my grief and prolong my suffering in unlife?
I wish there was a way that I could go through and prepare spells here, but I forgot to. Oh well. I'll go through and go ahead and make sure that I get that for the next day. He's the only one that we have to prepare spells for, so we just forgot to do that. Third level. We're gonna have no third level spells with Stink. We're gonna start getting our animated dead. We'll do Rage as our domain. Throw up and inflict serious wounds for her, as well as for damage. We'll throw up an animate dead just for the fun of it. Bone Shaker, throw up there. We already have a protection from alignment. We'll throw up a lesser restoration. And throw another Bone Shaker up and inflict moderate wounds. Actually, we're just going to do two inflict moderate wounds. We've got True Strike there once. Throw a Bane up. And we actually don't need the Blesses, but we'll redo the Blesses next rest so that I can at least cast them. Because Amiri can cast Bless, and I think Tristan also has Bless paired once. So we might end up switching the Bless out for like an Inflict Light and maybe like a Shield of Faith. Or two Shields of Faith, something like that. But here we go. Into the Verdant Chambers. Not even sure if we can survive this, but we'll see. Do a quick save real quick right here. Just in case we can't survive it, we can always quickly come back. We'll try mobility across.
Won't work.
Of course, build. Come on, y'all can get up. I have faith in y'all. I'm gonna try it again. We have plus 14. And we keep rolling. We literally rolled 2 7s in a row. We only need an 8 or higher. And we're like killing ourselves over here.
Done.
There, Jesus. Wasn't that hard.
Oh, sorry. Right.
We're gonna go ahead and channel some positive healing. Because he can't prevent enemies from healing from it, so we might as well use his when we need to.
I shall end this suffering.
Lindsay serves can you fire right. off bow shots.
Your death awaits.
Attack.
They go down.
Thanks for joining us, guys, joining the stream. If you enjoy watching the stream and you want to watch more, you can feel free to join us over on YouTube.
Forget it.
We only need a 5. What is this nonsense? Yeah, 14 is 19.
That was easy.
Jeez, okay.
The end draws near.
Phone trucking. Trucking.
Quiet footsteps. If there's gold, it's mine.
Got a Torag pendant. I need to rearrange. Don't have Aram on top of everybody. Throw it up a little. By the end of it, we're just gonna have a whole little slew of people. Bree meets you with a welcome rustle, but the nymph not appear. Perhaps because you failed to come along. Kind of what I figured was gonna happen. Okay, so we'll come back later when I'm alone. When I'm a higher level, because I really don't think we can take all of that stuff at our current level. We'll just come back at a higher level. Alright. We have already rested, though. There's no point in wasting our time going there if it was not gonna be fruitful. We'll just kind of do our outline around the river. And then proceed south from there. Alrighty, what do we got? I'll have to rearrange this again. We're just gonna keep going regardless of what you want.
Serves you right.
The transmuter. Get a sneak attack in. Guard the transmuter. Let's see if we can take out the transmuter before we do anything. Oh, he's an orc, of course.
Yes. Yes.
Repent.
Repent.
And he misses. Way to go. The bravest sorcerer I've ever seen. We're gonna 5 foot step over to this way, and we're gonna throw up a D3 giant frog that maybe they can go up on these people up here. There we go. Got that one taken care of. We'll throw a shot at this
guy
down.
You deserved it.
Didn't really get a whole lot done there, but that's okay.
Tear them apart!
That's some good damage. So you can make a melee touch attack as a standard action that causes the creature to become shaken. Okay, so that just makes me shaken. Not really. No, it's... I've got 45 charges. Go ahead and cast a shield. Give her a little bit more protection. For now. While everyone else is dealing with things. They're gonna be busy with these people up here for a little while.
Yes, yes.
Especially if they keep summoning things like that. Alright, we're gonna throw. Just throw a magic missile at this guy. Okay.
Your life ends low.
Let's throw up. Let's just get a flank on him. Help out Aram and
your
the
death awaits.
And apparently the frost is gonna come here. Okay, well, if the frogs are gonna be there, we're gonna have him come running up this way. Lindsay, we will have help.
Any last wishes?
They go down!
I don't want to get knocked prone. Then we're gonna 5 feet over. I guess just gonna
unworthy.
Keep swinging. There we go. Get a good hit in there. Just throwing out all the summons.
You forced my hand.
Bam. Hit him right in the back. Where'd the other? Oh. Okay. I guess to help it all out.
As will I.
What will the frog? They're coming to help it all too. Sneaky beaky lot. Yes, they are being very sneaky. It's almost like they're bandits or something. Got a lot of enemies still. Oh, there's a bunch of them. I did not even realize that they were there. Let's start by moving up 5 feet. And
this is enough. Where I step in.
Nice. This was a lot more people than I thought it was gonna be. Go get it, Labiri. Teach him a lesson. Yeah.
Wretched things.
There we go. Now Jethal can not move away because the frogs are blocking her. So I guess she's just gonna move up over here. Oh, that's not good. I was not expecting a whole person to be successful. We're injuring everyone and killing no one. Not going very well. We're gonna try to kill that guy.
Waste.
There we go, okay. I don't feel quite as bad now, because we actually killed somebody.
I'll loot your corpse.
Alright, come over here, frogs. That's not coming over here. She has plenty of help. I need help now. I'm gonna move the Smilodon kind of up in the center of everything so it can go to wherever it needs to go. Looks like it's starting to be down over this way.
Serves you right.
My god, he's still alive. Okay. Because he's dead.
Despicable.
There we go. Way. charge up. Oh, can't charge there. We can charge there though. Munch. Munch. Yeah. That's what we're talking about. Pow pow. Almost dead. Either one of these guys.
Become as dust.
Come as.
Stab their backs.
Alright, froggies. Finish them off. You're attacking the wrong. Yeah, no, it is a lot of bandits. Alright. You can at least finish them off. Sometimes your frogs attack the wrong dude.
You deserved it.
Let me be. You get up here. Hey. Yeah! Okay, you've got him under control. We're all good there. Did I give you? I only gave you.
The advance.
Okay. The frogs. They just attack the closest to you. I don't know exactly how their attacking kind of choice happens. I've seen the AI choose someone on the complete other side of the battlefield.
I'll try to make this swift.
Half the time I feel like they just are like, oh, there's an enemy. Okay, I'll pick that person. So I don't really
know. So fragile.
So fragile. We got it though, and we didn't have to waste too many spells. We were able to do it with just a few. And then a couple wand charges, but that's not a big deal. I am trying my very best to get used to using the wands a lot more, because they very quickly expire. And by expire, I mean... Yeah, I don't know why they don't let you control them either. Obviously, there's the capability there because they let you control the Smilodons and some of the other summons like the Peridot Wyvern you can control. So I don't know why they don't just give you control of their summons. I think it's partially due
to
in the pen and paper game, technically speaking, the summons are supposed to be under the control of the GM. I don't think I've ever met a GM that actually controls them, because it's just more stuff that they have to try to keep track of. They just let the players do it. But I think according to the rules, the GM is supposed to control it, which is probably why they did the AI controlled things. But yeah, I think it's silly that they don't let you control them. There's no reason not to, really. Move right along. Someone is in the road. Get ready. Not an enemy. Just someone. No. They do not need to be hostile to everyone. Oh, it's the young Dwimmer cat. Oh, I've got to rescue him. I love the Dwimmer cat. We gotta bring out all of the stops for him. I'm not raging for him, though. I don't need to rage for him. It's not that serious of a fight. I will go ahead and summon, though, for him.
Magnesium Turinos!
Have you encountered the Dwimmer cat yet in your playthrough, Jonathan? It'll talk to you. It's a fey creature. And then in future combats, you have a small chance of it coming in and joining you. So after you rescue him, if you actually don't kill him and if you actually protect him and keep him alive, there is a small chance in future random encounters in this area that he'll actually assist you in fighting people, so. We're just gonna go up here. Magic sword. Yeah, get him. Teach him a lesson. Oh, okay. I think he's dead. Smilly Smellodon. Oh, snap. Okay.
This won't kill me!
Okay. You're going to charge. Not charge. I don't know what we're gonna do. We're gonna do something. Not sure what yet. Maybe I'll just bless. Go up and cast bless. We're gonna do something, I promise. We aren't sure what yet, but it's something. Just hold your horse up there.
Any last wishes?
We're gonna delay until after Christmas. And we're gonna
cover me.
There we go. Like this guy. Yeah, there we go. That's what I was wanting to be. And the bear goes after him. Then we simply acid splash this one. Alright. Terribly sorry to all involved. We are gonna back up a little bit just to make sure that we don't hit anyone beyond the two that we're gonna have to hit. Alright, terribly sorry to Amiri and my character. I didn't want the healing.
Right.
Okay, Amiri went down. I was kind of worried about that, but that's okay.
Your life ends low.
Oof, yeah, Amiri got destroyed. It was for a valiant reason. We managed to get fire damage on four of them all at once. Oh, I should have raged. You are absolutely right. I don't... Negative 31 HP, it wouldn't have mattered, but...
Your death awaits.
She might not have gotten the, like, red blood thing around her, but who knows. Yeah, that 2 temp HP. Dwemercat does not forget those who help her. We shall meet again, perhaps. Who knows? Love Dwemercat. Dwemercat is our friend.
Grotus awaits us.
Magritium Turinos. Magritium Turinos.
Ask. Tashani Savitur. Tashani Savitur.
Esme Axe. Yes.
Alright. I think that's gonna be everything in this area. Just a standard engagement area. Nothing crazy. Hey, thanks for joining us, our additional viewer. Hope you're having a wonderful Thursday. Playing some Pathfinder Kingmaker, exploring the southern Gnarl Marches. Just encountered our Glimmercat friend and ally.
May we have a moment of
I don't
respite?
Think there's going to be anything at this lodge for us yet, but we'll go and take a look. Because I think it's specifically set up for future quests. I know of at least 2 quests that happen at that location. Yeah, it's just going to be a tavern currently. Although I don't think I've ever been here before quests. A sturdy, dour-faced dwarf stands before you. Hands on her hips, despite the wrinkles on her face, she looks more than capable of handling herself. She eyes you up and down. First time here, is it? House rules are simple. Don't trouble the other guests. Clean up your own mess. And don't cross me. Or the sky will be your roof. Name's Doomra. But don't call me if you need anything. Guests attend to themselves. Let me see your wares. Got Torax pendant. I don't know if it's worth the 400 gold cost, if I'm being honest. I don't know. We'll buy it and we'll see. Nothing else really. We do have a lot of food substances. We don't have a ton of honey. Just buy out all of our food. We're not gonna buy the camping supplies because I don't feel like we need it. Yeah, buy that. That when we start cooking things, we can always have plenty. Let's go upstairs, see what's upstairs, and I think we'll probably be done with this place. There's not really a whole lot happening.
It's just not my lucky
need
day.
A key.
I failed.
Need a key.
I'm sorry. Anything
hey.
Else? I failed. I'm sorry.
Okay, what? 27. Okay. Amiri is at a plus 11 base. We can get her up to a plus 13. This is the secluded lodge. There's a couple quests that you will eventually have that will deal with this place. So I will eventually come back to this place. Yeah, it's usually, I think it's like late act 2, early act 3. Stuff that you typically deal with it. We'll let Miri try.
Forget it.
No. Yeah. Okay.
It's just not my lucky day.
Come on. She only needed a 9 and she failed. Oh my god. Okay.
What you want?
Amiri. What armor check bonus do you have? Does it apply to the? You have a 1. Does technically apply. Oh, wait, that's. No, it does not apply. Okay. So we can get you up to a plus 12. 13. Get you up to a plus 13. If I cast Bless, that's plus 4. Basically the same as Lindsay. Yeah, sure. Do it. That. That. Then we'll just have Lindsay do her.
Just letting the ink dry.
Here I am.
And she still failed. All of that, and she still failed.
Adventures call to them.
Oh well. Perhaps we'll return.
Won't work.
Build that one too. That one was a 31, I guess, to be fair. You did need a good bit higher. Yeah, I did a quick save. Mostly because I haven't been doing a bunch of like quick save and reloads. I could totally do that. It really
Precisely.
Doesn't bother me doing that. But I didn't do quick save, so I can't just do reload. And you can. You can come back once every time you level to try it again. For the next time I level up, I'll just have to give it another shot.
My search was not in vain.
I didn't know that all this was back here. Ooh. Ooh. Maybe we go back upstairs. That's the hostess room key. A key from one of the rooms from the hunting lodge. We'll try some more Yeah, sling staff. It's a, I think halflings get proficiency with it naturally. No, they don't. Okay. I thought they... Doesn't do terrible... is it exotic? Yeah, it's an exotic weapon. And you use your strength for it. Feature allows you to add your strength bonus to the damage. So, it's basically just another type of ranged weapon. So it's a two-handed ranged weapon. Kind of similar to a bow. I think it's only ranged. I don't know. Has a 50-foot range. I don't know if there's a way to tell if it's and range. Okay. Is a sling staff melee? Question. Pathfinder. You can use a sling staff as a melee weapon and a ranged weapon. No, it's a ranged weapon only in Pathfinder. Yeah, it's just a ranged weapon. Nothing special, just ranged weapon. I have a key. Okay, well, unlock that one. And I lost the hostess room item. Hey-o.
That's easy.
Papers from Doom Ranch. Oh, I just robbed the owner of the tavern. Oh. I'm gonna leave before she finds out. It is like a lacrosse stick, you're right.
Quiet footsteps.
We're just not gonna mention the fact that we robbed the tavern. We're gonna keep that to ourselves.
My strength fades.
Okay. We're not going to go into the Camelands yet. We're going to head back over towards the southern Gnar Marches. A monster's den. Come up in here. And before we do this, we're going to make sure that we have all of our spells prepared. Sorcerer doesn't have to prepare any. And then he has all his prepared. We don't need Bless because we have two people that already have Bless prepared. So I'm thinking do a Inflict and maybe do a Shield of Faith. That. Alright, and then now we'll rest. We're going to manage. He has plus 8 here. Do we have anyone else who can camouflage? No, not really. With that, and I guess we'll throw a cook here. I can make most of these, but I want to make sure I have someone that can actually cook before I start doing it. I don't want to just waste my ingredients, you know? So, we'll wait until we have someone that can actually cook.
Listen, Harem, would you ever want to return to the Five Kings Mountains? To take up a hammer again? To feel the heat of the furnace?
Don't reopen old wounds. I have found my path, and I'm not turning from it. The mountains are my home no more, even if someone would like to see me there.
Poor Harem. Such a sad backstory. And a terrible cook. Alright, into the monster's den. Boom. 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 Alright.
The way seems clear.
More cooking supplies. And a recipe. Copy that recipe on it. Succulent sausages. Okay. Of a trap.
Onward.
Who will prevail?
An ancient. Oh god, that's level 13. Oh, okay. Ancient wyverns. I don't know if they have a breath weapon. Alright, let's throw up frogs. Might be in trouble. My man. Para, what am I gonna do with you? This seems like it'll be a great time to throw up some Gelly probes.
Tashani Savitur!
Okay. Works for me. Swing on him. Yeah, get him. Teach him a lesson. Heck yeah. Easy. Oh. Not easy. My bad. Gotcha. Rage. Charge.
I'm not doing it wrong. The spell is gone.
I have Harem because I got a quest to take him to Dwarven Ruins, and I know the Dwarven Ruins are in this area, so just kind of have him because I'm gonna need him for a quest. Throw up a blast. It's neutral, so that's like, oh, alright. Bone shaker. Damage there. Run in. Fight and miss. You're not doing that? Screw that quest.
I'll loot your corpse.
Go, Froggy, go! And you missed. Go, Froggy. Go, Skeleton. Hey, there we go.
This spell's purpose is different.
Bone Shaker. Kind of maneuver up that way. Stop. That is my skeleton you're hurting.
Tear them apart!
Ooh. Okay. Go, Amiri. Alright, bring it home. That was pitiful. I want you to know that that was beautiful, Christian.
Careful now.
Okay, Amiri, you can make that save anytime you want. Really do not have to keep taking con damage. Okay, thank you. Christ.
The end draws near.
Restoration on
Madrid. Turinos.
At least everyone else made their save. Aside from the summon. Okay.
Confide in me.
Christian.
Madrid. Turinos.
Rage for it. Grr! I couldn't rage. She had just raged, so.
Magritium Turinos.
Give me 5. I think you can only give me up to 4. You give me 2. Okay. What is she at? 13. Down 3 still. Do we have restoration stuff? Yeah, we do. Hey, there we go. That got her the rest.
Done with waiting.
On her spell list. Does she have access? I guess I just didn't use it. Okay. Cool. I do actually like Amiri having access to some of these kind of cleric spells. It actually makes it very nice to use, like, the scrolls and stuff. Sweet syrup. Just a jug of sweet syrup out here. Okay, that looks like it's everything. We'll head off. How are we doing? Oh, we're almost halfway to level 7. Why can't I go that way? Keep going around. I want to try to fill in this whole area, and then I'll get the middle. Finish. Okay. Can't go any further, I guess. I want to go that way, please. This way. Thank you. Thank you. There we go.
May we have a moment of respite?
I don't want to go into P-Tot. Not yet. P-Tat. Spotted enemies. Oh, everyone's tired. That's not good. I find it very weird that he says respite. It's definitely respite.
My instincts dull when I'm tired. I do
very
things
nice
my way.
Tired. Didn't.
Magritium Turinos!
And Lissy was called for.
What for Gollum?
Made up words? It is not. Shut up. It's not one of those made up words. Respite is definitely a word.
They go down!
Make quick work of them, I guess, Amiri. Okay. Apparently they came to play.
Stab their backs.
Alright, go get them, boys. That is not going and getting them. That's going and getting them. Thank you. At least someone knows what they're doing.
Serves you right.
I missed. What the heck? All right. Great. Everyone up there.
So it's come to this.
Collect all the treasure. I'm trying to get the treasure. Stupid dogs. Okay. Okay, I guess I already got it. Alright. I've gotten to the point where I really enjoy the rage spell. The spell rage is just really nice.
When we stop.
And we're gonna rest. Resty, resty.
After looking through their dwindling supplies,
yeah,
the party had
power.
A sinking feeling in their stomachs. We were about to find out whether fasting
you don't
is
get
truly good
after
for one's
it,
health.
But it's also
How's
slightly
that sound?
Weaker
you better
than a barbarian's
that we fight
rage.
Like devils in the day.
The big thing that you get
like
is the bonus like
night.
Hit and bonus to damage.
People sing songs about
you
great
don't get,
heroes.
Like, all the temporary hit
not
points,
snot-nosed, hungry tramps.
Or if you do, it might be based on the caster's level. I don't remember. I'd have to reread it. Let's see. Great. There we go. Plus 2 bonus to strength and con, plus 1 to will, minus 2 to AC. Otherwise identical to Barbarian's Rage, except they aren't fatigued at the end, while enraged cannot use spells. So yeah, you don't gain the temporary hit points, but you're also not fatigued at the end of it. You just gain the base bonus. So you get plus 1 to hit, plus 1 to damage, plus 1 HP per level, plus 1 to your will save, and minus 2 to your AC. So you're easier to hit, but you can hit easier and deal more damage. We're just connecting all the dots and all the lines, just being methodical with how we do things. Thought that the dwarven keep was somewhere around
respite?
Here. Not have a moment of respite.
My strength fades.
It's still pretty good, just because you're getting a flat boost. Well, we're not friends. I still think it's a pretty solid spell, just because there's no drawbacks to it aside from the AC penalty, and at higher levels the AC penalty doesn't really make a huge difference anyway. The only thing that you have to be careful with, because it's such a large AoE, you do have to be careful with placing it, because you can put it on your casters by accident, which means
my instincts dull
you're not
going
to be able
I'm
to
tired.
Actually cast spells. There's enemy by what? Nearby. Look. Nothing. You give me that kind of lie. There ain't no enemies nowhere. That's what I thought. Yeah, you can't cast if you're raging. Well, at least not if you're under the effect of the rage spell. I don't know if a barbarian
just
can cast
stay
while
at
raging.
Home.
I don't think you can.
You were a judge. You had respect.
Respect has very little intrinsic value. The question is whether it gets you what you want. And I wanted far more than respect could fetch me.
Yeah, but I mean, you can have both Bless and Rage on. Pretty sure they both work together. So Bless is a morale bonus. Rage is also a morale. Okay, so here's why they stack. Because even though they're both morale bonuses, Bless is a static morale bonus to your attack rolls, and on saving throws against fear. Rage, even though it's morale bonus, is a bonus to your strength and con. And because your strength and con go up, your to hit and your damage and your HP also goes up. The will save bonus doesn't stack, so if you're making a will save against fear, you'll only get the plus one, but everything else stacks. So if you have Bless and Rage up, then you'll have plus two to hit, plus one damage, plus one HP per character level, minus two to AC, and plus one on saves, basically. So, they can stack. And Bless is a minute per level, so by the time you reach like level 15, you're going to cast Bless and have that up pretty much the whole time. And then Rage is a round per level, so you're just going to be doing that in combat. So Bless is kind of like a pre-combat buff, Rage is a during-combat buff.
Precisely.
Can you make an epic pose? I need inspiration.
We'll actually probably be finishing up here shortly.
You deserved it.
That's a lot of dudes.
Repent.
What a waste.
Cover me.
Any last wishes?
Here and there. There we go. Nailed it.
Bring it!
Become as dust.
We'll go ahead and Bone Shaker him if we finish him off. I made a save. If he didn't make a save, we might have had a chance
wretched
of getting him.
Things.
Trying to keep the bear from taking too much more damage.
Your death awaits.
This is where I step in.
Let the bear finish this guy off. Okay, he did not finish him off.
You forced my hand.
Okay.
Tear them apart!
There we go. Alright. It is 11 o'clock, so I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and wind down the stream. We'll finish kind of exploring this whole area whenever start back on Tuesday, assuming everything goes as usual. So we'll pick back up here on Tuesday. We got a lot done, explored a whole lot. We got about halfway through our level 6, so if we get the same amount of progress done next time, we might even get to level 7. So, thanks for joining me the stream, guys. Can't wait to, play again. That. Have a good evening. Never give up, never slow, till I finally prove it. Never listen to the no's, I just wanna keep